This is Adventist World Radio Ghana.
Voice of Hope.
AWR Ghana. Voice of Hope. Voice of
Hope. This is Daylight Magazine, and under this segment, we have Reflections,
Youth Corner,
and Moment of Truth.
I am Kwejo Ansedu, and I'm presenting this with
Hannah B. Nyakun.
How are you doing today, Hannah?
I'm doing well, and you?
I'm doing well as well. I hope, dear listener, you enjoy our programs. Stay tuned.
AWR Ghana, Voice of Hope. Voice of
sins away.
Oh Lord, I want
two wings to veil my face.
Oh Lord, I want
two wings to fan my brow.
Oh Lord, I want
two wings to fly away so the devil won't do me no harm.
Will he come as a shadow in the
a mirror image. I hope you do. Come join me as we take a purposeful contemplation of our lives. This is the program Reflection.
Out there, this is Jocelyn Ahepo. We are going to talk about This is a New Day. This is a new day. My God has given me this day, which I call today, to use as I will. I can waste it or grow in its light and be a blessing to my world. What I do with today is crucial. Also, when the future arrives tomorrow, I will rename it today. Therefore, today automatically gains entry into the history books of records. Though it was once in the realm of the future, can I boldly say I made full use of the gift called today that was given to me by God. I want you out there to make very good use of the gift God has given you. Each and every day, live your life and live it to its maximum with all the opportunities, with all the advantages that is at your hand. I'm Jocelyn Ahegbo. Thank you.
Listener, this segment is about the youth and their lives in today's world. The program is Youth Corner.
Aimlessly beneath the barren sky, leave it to me, I'll lead you home. So afraid that you will not be found, it won't be long before your sun goes down. Leave it to me, I'll lead you home.
Hello and welcome to Youth Corner. My name is Afre Niyama Keke. Today we continue with our discussion on non-curricular activities. Jared Ofe and Amos Eshufi are here with me to help out with the discussion on this particular issue. And we continue with how important it is for Christians and students, much more so, to engage or take up non-curricular activities. More specifically, whilst in school.
It's important you involve in non-curricular activity. The reason being that, you see, you would actually develop your skill. You are going to be exposed to certain things you never knew. You're also going to gain knowledge. You're also going to be confident. Knowledge is power. Yes, and the moment you have knowledge of something, you are confident whenever it comes to that particular area. So these are some reasons for which one should involve in non-curricular activities. Also, they serve as platform for other issues in the future, so you may never know. So it's very necessary.
Okay. Let me come to you, Jared. How important is it for Christians and students in this regard to take up non-curricular activity?
I think that, first of all, it gives a sense of achievement. If, let's say, you are a member of a team in the church and you're able to come up with a program that went on successfully, you realize that you have some kind of feelings that you've been able to achieve something. So it gives a sense of achievement. Secondly, it's important because it also gives experience. You tend to learn a lot from indulging in this kind of non-curricular activities. Then thirdly, you realize that we're in a very dynamic environment and we need people who are not just doing one thing, but who can do a lot of things at hand.
To be some versatile. In that
exactly, way. Versatile. So it also helps us fit more into this dynamic environment. And also, sometimes it brings opportunities. Let me give this example. I had mates in the high school that did not perform so much, but then they were absorbed by the school because they had this kind of skills and they did sports. And the school needed some people who would be representing them at zonals and other competitions. See, so it brings opportunities sometimes to us. So it's very important to
indulge. Okay, interesting point there. So it opens or enables you to access to other opportunities because of which particular non-curricular activity you are pursuing. But let's look at what factors one must take into consideration as a Christian when you are choosing or selecting one non-curricular activity from the other.
I personally have some three main factors that I consider. And I call them the HIP. First of all, you should consider how it's going to help you and others. Is it going to help me? How is it going to benefit others? Then secondly, consider your interest. Do I really have interest in it? Because it is important. If you do not have enough interest, you would end up getting back from it. Then also the third thing, how much time will it take from me? You see, how much time are you going to spend on it? So it is important to consider these three factors when you are choosing an
curricular activity. Well, you talked about interest and the fact that the interest is what will drive you at the end of the day. But what would you say to the argument that there are certain things you necessarily do not have an interest in? For instance, if it's about working in your school's radio station or TV station,
mm-hmm.
Prior to working there, you never had an interest, but later on you are able to develop that level of interest as well. Or even singing in the choir, in the church, you didn't have that level of interest. Later, you could develop that interest. How do you reconcile that with this?
First of all, I think that even before you participate in these activities, you are supposed to have an interest. If, let's say, for example, you're working in the library...
Yes, my point is, can't the interest be developed along the way?
It can be developed. You can develop passion for it as you enter into it, but then you still need to have the interest
beforehand.
Yes, beforehand. You still need to have, because it's not supposed to be something that it's obligatory. Do it. You must have some interest to be able to pursue it.
Okay, I'll come to you on that same issue of interest, whether it should be beforehand, because it can also, you can also develop the interest in it. But first and foremost, what are the factors or things that a Christian should take into consideration when choosing a non-curricular activity?
Yes, I will talk about two. One is time. As my brother said, time. How much time yourself you have, how much time you can give out. Another point is your abilities. Yes, what can you do? You want to go for the position of an ESL, meanwhile you can't address a crowd. I mean, you need to consider these things before you move ahead. I think these two points are very necessary too.
Rather interesting. Let me ask you same about whether the interest should be there beforehand or it should be something you will be able to develop along the way. You were saying that before you entered the choir, even though you had a passion, you did not necessarily have a good voice, which would make you believe you could sing. And later on, you develop a high level of interest or a higher level of interest. Should you always be passionate about it? Should you always have it as an interest before you go in for it?
I think it's necessary you have an interest. Now, when we were in school, before the ESRC president for our time was chosen, someone came to me, one of the people who were contesting, wanted me for a running mate. I told him I don't have the interest for that position. Of course, he had to force me, but of course, I didn't have the interest. So I had to just let it go. Yes, if you don't consider that, what if you don't develop the interest when you get into it? It's dangerous. Of course, you might develop the interest whilst you are in it. But what happens if that interest does not come? Usually, you tend to develop the interest when everything is going well.
Okay. You think it's too risky, I think,
it's,
to do?
It's risky. Because when you're moving on and then the interest is not coming, you will now be doing things anyhow. And that one is not good.
Yes.
You will now be doing things anyhow.
Yes.
But it's not really likely that you will be able to develop the interest.
It's likely you will be able to develop the interest.
The impression you're creating is that it's too risky to do that.
It's very risky to do that. You know, you should know that you are choosing this particular area to go and give out your best. You don't have any interest in that area. You chose the choir. You went. Anytime you are given a solo to lead, it flops. You should know that, of course, people will, you know, heckle.
Yeah.
You understand? If you don't really have the interest, I am telling
you'll give
you,
up, eh?
You'll give up.
Okay, so that's how important the interest should be or is, really, insofar as choosing a non-curricular activity as a Christian and a student, much more so. Of course, on that note, we end this edition of Youth Corner. I've been here with Jared Ofer and Amos Eshrifi. We have talked about a number of things, including the factors that you should consider when choosing a non-curricular activity as a Christian, and also how important it is to engage in non-curricular activities.
World Radio Ghana,
Voice of Hope.
AWR, Voice of Hope. We will bring you joy. Keep hope alive.
You can contact us on
Adventist World Radio Ghana, Valley View University, P.O. Box. AF 595, Adenta, Accra, Ghana, West Africa. Or if you have access to the internet, send us an email through radio@vvu.edu.gh. Or better still, you can call us on 030-7051-058. The number again, 030-7051-058.
Something I don't.
He created the heavens, he created the earth.
Tell me something that I don't know.
He became a human through a virgin birth, yeah.
Tell me something that I don't know.
He amazed the wise men.
We know.
Tell me something, something I don't know.
Tell me something that I don't know. Please tell me something I don't know. Tell me something that I don't know.
Already know
something I don't. Something I don't.
He gave sight to the blinded. With all kinds of breakthroughs,
I'm very impressed. But as to the meaning and purpose we live,
there's only one answer
creation can give.
He was taken. Cherished listener, this is the moment of truth, where truth is presented with precision and exactness. Enjoy this encounter of a lifetime.
Calling for you and for me.
Calling for you and
see on the portals, he's waiting and watching. Watching for you and for me.
You are welcome to Moment of Truth. I am Pastor Francis Tufo, There are certain things that we see about people who are faithful. And I want to talk about five things that we see about people who are faithful. The first thing is dependability. Faithful people are trustworthy and reliable. Others can lean on them. They keep their promises. Secondly, commitment to contract. Faithful people respect the terms of the agreement they enter into, not only in their professional relationships, but their personal relationships as well. They value integrity, and they do not cheat on their partners. Third, consistency. They are very consistent in their truthfulness. They are not seasonal in being faithful. They stick through the good as well as bad times. They do not deny the cause of faithfulness in difficult times. Fourth, responsibility. They are able to successfully handle roles and assignments. Responsibility also means being able to step forward and take decisions when you have to. It is also about standing up to the task at hand and not giving excuse for non-performance. The last one is promotion. Faithful people in every level ultimately get exalted. "Well done, my good slave," was something that Jesus told the servant who was good. "You prove you could be trusted in a very small matter. Take charge of 10 cities." This is found in the book of Luke, chapter 19, verse 17. I want to ask you, what will your answer be when these questions are put to you? Can Christ depend on you? Can your spouse depend on you? What about your friends and co-workers? How committed are you to God and your spouse? Do you perform your task as a worker, or you give excuse as the bad servant? Your answers to these questions serve as a measure of your faithfulness. Most people these days show their unfaithfulness in how they relate with money. When it comes to money, many people falter. People believe these days that money can do everything, so they cheat, they kill, they lie in order to acquire them. I quite remember that in Ghana, I was traveling, and as soon as I entered into a big bus, I saw a big inscription on money. This is how it went. I saw something called M-O-N-E-Y. That is money. M stood for "many will die because of me." So here it means money is token. O stood for "others will suffer because of me." N stood for "nothing is done without me." And "ye" was "everything is done by me." And the last one, which was "why," was "yes, I am the ruler of the world." As I stood, I just pondered about the inscription that I saw in the bus. And I was talking to myself. I said that it is true that many people will die because of money. Others will suffer because of money. But I did not believe that money can do everything. We know that money can buy bed. It cannot buy sleep. Money can buy food, but appetite to eat, the money doesn't provide. Money can give somebody accommodation, but it doesn't provide peace. It can give a woman, but not a wife, a man and not husband. So money cannot do all things. I want to tell you that the best promotion that one can get is for God to take him or her from this sinful world to heaven. Our faithfulness to our master can be a passport to heaven, because Bible has said that in Revelation, the book of Revelation, chapter 2, verse 10, "Be faithful till death, and I will give you a crown of life." This quotation gives credence to the fact that faithfulness is not an elective in school of life. It is a core subject that any serious person cannot overlook. In the story of the talent, the good servants were promoted and rewarded, but the unfaithful servant was demoted and punished. Jesus, who has traveled to heaven to prepare a place for his servants, will come one day to meet two classes of servants, the faithful and those who are not faithful. Jesus will come to promote and reward the faithful people, and the unfaithful people will be thrown into fire, where they will be crying and grinding of teeth. Our loving God wants us to be with him, but we have power to choose to be loyal or disloyal, faithful or unfaithful, heaven or hell, blessings or burdens, appointments or disappointment, fortunes or misfortunes. Let us choose to be faithful. Before the arrival of the master after a long trip, all the servants were stewards. The distinction between the good and the bad was not known. But when he finally came, the distinction became clear. But there was a distinction between those who were good and those who were bad. I want to end by telling you this story. There was a prominent physicist or scientist who came together and predicted that flood would signal the end of the world in 3 days. A television station called on leading religious personalities to advise people on how they should react. The Pope told his church members to repent their sins, but the Buddhist monk instructed his people just to seek inner peace by searching for their inner selves. The rabbi told his followers, okay, we've got 3 days to learn how to swim. Very soon this world will come to an end. Jesus is on his way to come to take his faithful servants home. We should not wait for 3 days to learn how to be faithful. Let us learn it and practice it today. If we are faithful, we know. If we are not, we know. So let us choose to be faithful until our master comes to examine our work. May God bless you today. Thank you for listening. I want to pray with you. Father, I thank you. Bless the person who has been listening. Continue to cater for their needs and continue to give them understanding. Help them to overcome unfaithfulness and help them to be faithful. I thank you for answered prayer in Jesus' name. Amen.
This is our address. Adventist World Radio Ghana, Valley View University, P.O. Box AF 595, Adenta, Accra, Ghana, West Africa. Or if you have access to the internet, send us an email through radio@vvu.edu.gh. Or better still, you can call us on 030-7051-058. The number again, 030-7051-058. I am blessed being a part of this program. Hannah, what about you?
The same here.
So I believe, listener, you did too. This has been once again Kwejo Ansendu and
Hannah B. Nyaku.
God bless you.